Captain. Communique coming in from Starbase 72, Priority 5.
Oh, up to Priority 5. That must mean that Starfleet considers this mission to be more important than the last 9 missions they sent us on.
Yeah, it would probably only be Priority 8 or 9 if they were only sending us to wash Starbase 17 again.
Mr. Martin, hull deionization is a very important procedure.
Well, put it on screen.
Ah, Captain, I have a very important mission for you.
Oh, good. You know, you can always count on me for your very important missions.
It appears we have lost contact with a particular Oberth-class vessel.
Oh no, not the Hansel again.
Yes, the Hansel. It's been missing for 3 weeks. We assume they're having navigational difficulties.
Really? And why would you assume that? Just because that was the problem the last 4 times you sent me out to find them. Let's not jump to any hasty conclusions.
The Hansel was last seen in the vicinity of the Gamaved asteroid belt.
You sent the Hansel into an asteroid belt? What, were you trying to lose them?
Really, Captain?
Well, can't we just let it go for a couple of weeks? Let them work it out for themselves a bit. Who knows, maybe they'll turn up.
Captain, I should hardly have to remind you that all Starfleet ships are important, even those whose performances have been less than stellar.
Well, I still don't see why I should have to be the one who goes and finds them. I mean, there've got to be plenty of other ships closer to the Gamaved asteroid belt.
The bottom line is that someone's got to do it, and everyone else is doing something important. Starfleet out.
This is just like...
Shut up. Captain's personal log, stardate 459.08.0. Starfleet has sent me on yet another tedious, trivial mission to retrieve my old Academy friend, Darius Figg, again. Figg's navigator is about as competent at stellar cartography as our own Mr. Vebnik is with warp field dynamics and drive maintenance, and they seem to get lost about as often as we have total systems failure. Figg once offered to trade me, but I figured I'd stick with a known commodity. At least Vebnik hasn't blown up the ship yet. Of course, that's probably the only way I'm liable to get a better ship around here. That gives me an idea. Computer, delete those last 2 sentences.
Commander, we are now entering the Gamaved asteroid belt.
Acknowledge, Ensign Christopher. You're now entering the Gamaved asteroid belt.
Oh, goody. Lieutenant Martin, you might as well scan the system for the Hansel.
Scanning the system. The asteroids are extremely dense and composed of vitreous and melodic materials which interfere with our scanners. We will not be able to detect the Hansel using our long-range array.
Yada, yada, yada.
However, I am detecting a series of navigational beacons left on various asteroids in a series. It's almost like they were leaving a trail for us to follow.
Like breadcrumbs. Like last time. Okay, Mr. Benson, lay in a course. Thrusters ahead. Let's get this over with.
Aye, Captain. Captain.
What? Found them already?
No, the trail. It's losing coherency. Losing coherency, I say. It's like a giant space bird swooped down and ate up all the breadcrumbs.
Perhaps the trail ends because the Hansel entered that large planetoid over there. As if it were entering a giant gingerbread house.
Maybe they've got the Hansel cooking in a giant space oven.
Okay, that's it. This metaphor is over. Fini. Now, we can't use long-range sensors, and we can't follow the trail. So that means we're going to have to split up and search for them in the shuttles. I want all essential crew members to form shuttle parties in Shuttle Base 1 and 2. I'll go with Lieutenant Martin. Rand, you take Ensign Christopher. Counselor, you go with Mr. Benson.
Oh, Captain, don't make me go with Mr. Benson.
Okay. Rand, you take Benson. Fortas, you go with Ensign Christopher.
Can I have my own shuttle?
No.
Captain, if all the officers are in the shuttlecraft, who will be running the ship?
Mr. Vebnik, I am leaving you in command. Ensign Bob will remain behind to assist you as acting first officer. The rest of the officers will be in the shuttlecraft.
Understood, Captain.
Now, I want you to be extra careful while you're in command. I wouldn't want you to blow up the ship or anything.
Oh, don't worry about that, Captain.
All the same, I'd like for you to have a look at the antimatter containment system while I'm gone. Maybe you run a few diagnostics, see if you can't soup it up a bit.
But Captain, you told me never to go near the antimatter containment.
That was before. But, why don't you, count to 100 first?
Can do, Captain.
Lieutenant Martin,
one,
warm up the shuttle,
two,
we're leaving now!
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Shuttle Borel to Shuttle Hausdorff. Captain, I'm initiating search pattern Delta.
Knock yourself out, Rand.
Shuttle Poincaré to Shuttle Hausdorff. We are initiating our search as well.
Good. You do that, Ensign Christopher.
Why is it we can not use the long-range sensors, but we can communicate with each other through subspace?
Well, that's just a totally different thing. Duh.
Well, should we initiate a search pattern?
Why should we bother? I mean, I could sense they're that way.
What? You can? Why didn't you tell the captain when we were on the ship?
I sensed she didn't want me to. '94, '95, '96, '97, '98, '99, 100!
Okay, Bob, let's break this baby open.
Is the Galois still within sensor range?
Yes, Captain.
Are you scanning any problems with the antimatter containment system?
No.
Warp core breach in progress, perhaps?
The systems appear to be functioning normally. Normally for our ship, at least.
Well, I guess I better give Mr. Vebnik a call then. See what he's up to. Shuttle Hausdorff to Galois.
Vebnik here, Captain.
Mr. Vebnik, have you completed your overhaul of the ship's antimatter containment system?
Not quite.
I see. Well,
Are you using all the proper safety protocols for dealing with antimatter?
Bob, put those safety goggles back on.
I can see this is getting us nowhere. Look, Mr. Bebnik, I was having a little trouble last week with the ship's self-destruct mechanism. It kept sticking when it got to 0-1. Why don't you check this out for me?
Oh, okay, Captain. I'll get right on it. Bebnik out. Bob, drop what you're doing. We've got a new job.
Commander, we're picking up something in section 15.
Put on the viewer.
Aye, sir.
Oh my god, it's one of those giant space cornucopia doomsday machines.
Giant space cornucopia doomsday machines? Why, in my day we had way bigger giant space cornucopia doomsday machines. Why, that thing couldn't even digest a small moon.
Well, certainly giant for a cornucopia, though perhaps it's not so giant for a space cornucopia. Look, it's digesting one of the Hansel's navigational beacons.
I told you, there's the Hansel now.
All right, I'll try to raise them, sir. Opening hailing frequencies, now.
Oh, boy, are we glad to see you guys. You're not lost too, are you?
No.
Whew, that's good. You Galois guys always come through for us.
Galois? What do you mean, Galois? It's Galois. Galois.
Well, aren't we fancy.
All right, lock onto us. We'll take the Hansel back to the Galois.
No, that's not Hansel, that's Hansel.
Bob, will you put that antimatter down and come and help me?
What do you want me to do, Mr. Vebnik?
Here, just hold these two power coupler wire thingies.
Mr. Vebnik, haven't you gotten that self-destruct mechanism to work yet?
It should be all right now, Captain. You just have to jiggle it a little.
What does that red light mean?
One second, Captain. Gotta go. Bending out.
Captain, at this rate, he'll blow the ship up before we get back.
Let's keep our fingers crossed.
I say it's not giant at all! Oh, my old ship! It's after us! Darn it! Chased down by a teeny-weeny space cornucopia! What are we gonna do? To the ship!
Any change in the Galois systems, Lieutenant Martin?
No, sir.
Captain,
the Borel is hailing us. Perhaps they've found something.
Very well. Put them on screen. What is it, Rand?
Captain, we're being chased by a slightly larger than average sized space cornucopia. It's trying to eat us.
What? I've heard of those things. Don't they devour whole planets?
Yes, Captain, I believe they do.
The giant ones do anyway.
Well, what's your plan?
I'm fleeing back to the ship.
But how will that help us? You'll be putting the Galois in danger.
Thank you, Lieutenant Martin. Very good, Commander. We will monitor your progress. Shuttle House Starf out.
Oh, Captain. The other shuttle is returning, and they have the Hansel in tow.
What? Already?
Captain, the Hansel is hailing us.
Very well. Put them on screen. Well, Captain Fig, I see we've completed another exciting mission of finding your loser ship. How am I ever supposed to get promoted to command of a bigger starship if I never have any time to go on any real missions?
Hey, listen, you. It's not like I haven't had to tow your sorry ship back to Starbase every time the warp drive mysteriously stops working. What about my promotion?
Yeah, and don't forget the time that we had to retrieve your ejected warp core from that system. The one with the stars and those planets?
I see you still have Navigator O'Leary on board. Well, Mr. O'Leary, allow me to bring you up to date. You are in the L8 star system in the Gamavid asteroid belt, and it's a Tuesday.
I know what the date is. L8 Gamavid belt.
Captain, we've arrived at the rendezvous point. The Doomsday Machine is in pursuit. It'll arrive at the Galois in less than 5 minutes.
Commander Benson, didn't your old ship encounter one of these?
Well, not like one of these. That one was giant! Giant, I say!
But how did you destroy it?
Well, it wasn't easy to destroy it, let me tell you. Those things have a hull made out of solid neutronium. We had to take our big Constitution starship and ram it down that thing's giant throat. But as for Doomsday Junior here, you could probably do it in with an Oberth class starship.
Captain Thelev, I'll beam all of my crew over to the Galois, and then ram the Hansel right down that planet eater's throat.
You'll ram your ship down its throat, but my ship is already mostly evacuated. I'll be the one to destroy this thing.
O'Leary, beam my crew over to the Galois immediately.
Oh, no you don't. Mr. Vebnik, raise the shields immediately. We'll bring the shuttle in manually to evacuate you.
Aye, aye, sir.
Mr. Vebnik, I'm going to be taking the Galois directly into the space cornucopia. I need for you to rig the ship to self-destruct. Set a delay countdown for 6 minutes.
How about 4 minutes and 51 seconds?
Yeah, that'll work. You and Bob get in Shuttle Hausdorff with Martin, and be prepared to beam me out, and order the rest of the crew to the escape pods.
They've already gone. Word to the wise, Captain. Give Deck 7 a wide berth.
Right.
All Galois shuttle, regroup and dock with the Hansel. The Captain is taking the Galois into the planet eater.
Into the planet eater? Thank God that assignment didn't last too long. I mean, plotting course now, sir.
It's tough to lose a ship, even in a heroic, alien device-destroying mission like this one. I wonder how the Captain's taking it. Yes, 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 yes! Oh, yes! Finally, finally! Destroying the little tiny ship! Now I'll have a great big ship! Bye-bye, little ship! Bye-bye!
It's just not fair. Thelev gets to destroy her little ship in this grand heroic gesture. She'll probably get command of some shiny new silver spaceship herself. And I'm stuck with the Hansel.
Fuck up, Captain. There's bound to be another space cornucopious thing somewhere.
Finally! Finally I'm going to get a bigger ship! I'm going to destroy this little ship and get a much bigger ship! Look, little ship! You're going to go in there! This is going to be so fabulous! Gentlemen, I suggest you beam me aboard!
Confirmed, it worked. The cornucopia is dead.
Huh? Oh, good, good, yes.
Well, congratulations, Captain Thelev. I guess you finally won. Mr. O'Leary, plot a course for home. Let's head back to base.
Aye, Captain. Home. Where are we again?